All right, this is going to be a non-spoiler review of The Nevers for HBO episode 2. So let's get right to it. What's the story? Well, essentially, Malady just kidnapped somebody, and Amal is going to try to help the person who is kidnapped. And we're continuing the story from episode 1, where they established that Amal and Penance are trying to help the quote touched, who are usually women with powers, though. There are some men with powers, but obviously the focus here is going to be on women because of Joss Whedon's past work. We're going to put aside the controversies in his personal life, but if you know Whedon, he has usually concentrated his narratives on strong female women, and this is no exception. So, is this an improvement over the other episode? No, I think more or less this is a 6.5. It's not boring, but the narrative is fairly sluggish. I was sort of excited at the beginning because there's a little bit of a funny introduction with a bit of a joke. But the problem with that is the more I keep thinking about this world building, it didn't really make any sense. Basically, we get introduced to somebody new, and they're surprised that it turns out they're one of the touched as well. But you keep thinking to yourself, well, wait a minute, it's been a while since the so-called touched phenomenon happened. So why is this person surprised? Why are they in a state of shock? I still like the scene because they did something really funny with a special effect. I don't want to ruin it for you, but it was very funny. But it didn't really make sense. Why is this character reacting this way? Wouldn't they have enough time to know, yeah, there is these things called the touched. You may be one of them. Why would she be that shocked? It didn't quite make a lot of sense. There's a lot of things with the world building in this that doesn't really add up because Malady is one of the few touched who are not completely evil, but they're very dangerous. So of course they're a concern, and that does make sense. And I realize what Malady is. She's basically a kind of Joker character, and that's fine. So the character doesn't have to make sense. They don't have to have a strong logic, but her actions just seem chaotic. I guess she's going to kind of be the spike of this series, and we know where this is going to go. She's going to do something terrible. She's going to have to get redeemed, etc., etc. I keep thinking to myself, the lead actress is just not charismatic to really pull this off. Amal is fine as a character. I just don't really care what's happening to her. And the so-called slicing she does, where she sees little bits and pieces of the future, it still looks visually really weird. It feels like she just has a weird coke habit. Like her nose just twists and she's like, and it's just like, okay, all right, calm down. So it just seems it's like a little off center. I'm still not getting why we need to care about this. Like, Penance still remains sort of the most charismatic person in the whole cast. And I do like her, and her dialogue is pretty witty this episode. So I like that. I appreciate that the writing did get a little sharper this episode, but again, there's still no really strong logic propelling the narrative forward. And they are adding a lot more character details, but I'm still puzzled as to why. For instance, we do learn a little bit more about the so-called baddies. If you notice my other review, they're basically coming off like the Watchers Council from Buffy. In fact, there's still so much Buffy in the Nevers, it's pretty shocking, but not where you would expect. I'm not going to ruin it for people, but in season 8, which is a comic book they did for Buffy, certain things happen to those characters there, and they're kind of plucking one of the ideas they played with Dawn, and they're applying it to one of the cast here in the Nevers, and that's fine. I don't need Joss to be totally new, but he directed this episode, and it just didn't have the kind of kinetic charge that I usually associate with his directing. He's a much better writer than director, but most of his directed episodes are pretty strong. But this one only felt kind of just above average. And it's written by Jane Espenson, and I'm not an Espenson fan, but on average, she's pretty good. But here it just feels like we're still waiting for the reason we should care about this world. And I'm still not getting it. Are the touched really that abnormal? Because again, their power levels are sometimes very low. So is he trying to say something deep about how any abnormality would be a cause for concern in Victorian England? I'm still having a lot of questions as to what exactly we're up to. It may seem like a paradox, but sometimes some of the crew is a little bit too melodramatic, and I think they're too into the role. So I think if they eased up on the method acting, that would be a lot better. And I'm still not clear about what exactly the threat or the disposition is, because there's a lot of X-Men in this. And I'm wondering, well, is it about preventing a kind of apocalyptic future where the touched are out of control, or they have too much power, or conversely, the touch star actually necessary to stop the apocalypse? Again, it's not clear, why is this such a major thing? Is it just because this is a very, very conservative era? Why don't the touch just move? It's not like mutants in the X-Men. From the naked eye, they don't really look abnormal, so presumably a lot of them could just hide. There's only a few of them that have their powers that are really, really obvious to other people, right? They'll stand out. A lot of them just look normal, so I keep wondering, why is this an issue? So again, the story logic still doesn't appear strong enough for me to care, but we're going to keep going with this. So it's enough there. Probably still the strong points are the costumes and special effects. I did like how the special effects were integrated into the story. It's very smooth and calm. But beyond that, I'm not able to see what's really extraordinary yet about the Nevers. All right, this has been a non-spoiler review of episode 2 of the Nevers for HBO. Thanks for listening.